In this how-to video, we will focus on a part of AMS called REST. With the REST API, we offer third-party applications access to the AMS backend. In this video, we will show a couple of REST commands that can be used to create and authorize an AMS user. The tool we use in this video is the Swagger UI. That is a web-based application that can be used to communicate directly with the AMS server. From the previous video, we learned that we need an user with unlimited API access who can control the Swagger tool. And that we also need to create a JSON configuration file to tell the identity server to allow that user with a session timeout. We start this video by creating a new AMS employee. We will authorize in Swagger with the REST admin that we created in preparation. From now on, the session will be active for 4 hours, as is configured in the JSON configuration file. Let's start now with creating a user. We move to the Employees section. We first need to check if we can find an existing user and what its division ID will be. We need that ID in the next part. The first user we find is Administrator. Let's check its division ID. We need to create the new user in the same division. Now we move to the Employees Post section, because that is where we can create. Click on the Try It Out button to create an example. Remove the lines we don't need and modify the lines we want. The division ID is important and already there. The person we are going to create is Charles Smith, the CEO of Roho Security. We add the details that are of importance. All, except last name and division ID, are optional. When our modifications are ready, we click on Execute. Swagger will send the request to the server and the server will answer in a JSON format. That response comes with a code and a description. Code 201 tells that the employee is created successfully. Let's check that in AMS by looking up Charles from the person page. There he is, with all the details we added. Now we need to provide a badge for Charles so that he can identify himself at the door. To add a badge directly to a user, we need to know the user ID. That can be found in the Employees section. From the response, we will scroll down until we find Charles. Then we copy his ID to the clipboard. Now we can jump to the section Access Cards. And paste the just copied person ID to the request body of the post command. Code data is the card number but in 8-byte hexadecimal format. Each zero presents a 4-bit hexadecimal number. So the total length is 64 bits. The first 32 bits come from the customer code. For this badge, it is the decimal number 9000. With the Windows calculator, we can convert decimal to hexadecimal. Copy that to the clipboard and paste it at the end of the first 32 bits of the card number. So that number starts with 4 zeros or 16 empty bits. The first 8 hexadecimal numbers are now 00002328. The second 32-bit part is the unique part of the card number. That is the decimal number 380509. If you convert that to hexadecimal, it takes 20 bits. These are the end of the card number with 3 leading zeros or 12 empty bits. So that last 32 bits will be 0005CE5D. The used card technology is MIFARE Classic. But could also be MIFARE DESFIRE, Legic Advant, or iClass. The data type is the encryption algorithm. For Bosch cards, this is normally Bosch encoding with a key length of 63 bits. Clicking execute will do the card assignment. The description tells us that the access card is created successfully. Let's see how that looks in AMS. So far so good, but we still need to set an authorization before Charles can really enter. Without an authorization, no one can enter anywhere. Our CEO definitely needs access throughout the building. Let's have a look to see what authorizations are currently available in the system. There are two authorizations. We want Charles to have the second one, authorization to enter the office building. So we copy that ID. Now we move to the person's part in Swagger. There we find a post command to directly assign an authorization to a person. Authorization is known and can be copied from the clipboard. But now we need the person ID again. Let's pick it up from the employees section. There is Charles and there is his person ID. Copy that. And paste it back in the empty field in the person part of the authorization section. By clicking execute, Charles will get the necessary authorization assigned. Let's check AMS again to see if it is there. Yes, it is. So now Charles has a valid badge and a valid authorization. And can enter the building. This concludes the second video in the Access Control API How-To series. In the next video, we will introduce the gRPC interface.